Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to this channel, my name is Christina. And on this channel, I mostly talk about how to make money online so that you can travel a lot more. So today I want to cover and answer a question that I've been getting a lot from you guys, which is, do I have to market my own classes? How can I ensure that my classes are going to be filling up? So I think that's a really good question. And I wanted to give you guys a little bit more background and context about how this works. So in this video, I'm going to be answering that question. And I'm also going to be going over tips for enrollment. Okay, so the short answer is you do not have to market your classes. This is the beauty of OutSchool. OutSchool is really, really good at marketing your classes. So specifically, these are some of the things they do. And I'm gonna read straight from the OutSchool website, and I'll pull it up also here on the screen for you guys. So OutSchool says, I quote, "We promote your scheduled classes via weekly email roundups, personalized email notifications, automated Facebook ads, and other social media." So OutSchool also mentions that they highly recommend that you schedule your classes 2 weeks ahead of time. So in other words, if you just created a course and you created it on August 1st, they recommend that you schedule the class to be open on August 14th, for example, or August 15th. So they highly recommend that you schedule 2 weeks out to maximize the promotion they can do for your classes. Okay, tip number one. So for tip number one, it actually comes from my own experience. For some reason, when I listed my first course in OutSchool, I actually set my first class to private. Somehow it defaulted to private, and I had all of these private classes. So for like the first week or two, I didn't get any bookings because my class was set to private and other parents and students couldn't find my course. So I just want to make sure that you guys realize that there is a difference between setting your course to private or setting your course to public. So make sure that when you are setting up your class, that you hit that public option. Another thing I highly recommend is to surf through OutSchool and just check out other classes. I think it's really helpful to see what other teachers are doing. I think it's really helpful to see how they're selling themselves, right? So it's a good idea to check out their intro videos. So there's an intro video to your profile, and there's also an intro video to the actual class. So it's helpful to see kind of what's out there, and you can also see how many reviews this teacher has, right? What the prices are. You don't have to reinvent the wheel, in other words. You can just head on over to another listing, and of course, do not copy anyone's work, but you can learn from the way that other teachers sell themselves and market themselves. So that's another tip I have for you guys. Okay, so tip number two is to experiment with different options. So what do I mean? So you come out with your first class. Maybe your first class is a Harry Potter discussion class, right? So maybe that class is, you have an age range of 9 to 12 or 9 to 13, right? You may want to offer that class with a younger age range. Because remember, on OutSchool, you can teach kids between the ages of 3 to 18. So you have so many kids to market to, and for whatever reason, there may be kids that want to learn about that topic that are younger or older. Or maybe you've already taken the class and students may have siblings that are older or younger that are interested in taking your course. So you can experiment with different age ranges. Another thing you can experiment with is the types of classes you're offering. So what do I mean by that? Well, in OutSchool, you're able to offer a one-time class, meaning this class meets once and that's it. You never see the students ever again. Or you're able to offer a class that may last 4 weeks. So more like a camp style class. So there are a lot of different options that you can experiment with. So if you do have a class that's a one-time class, you can experiment with offering classes that are a little bit longer in nature. And that could be something that's really appealing to parents. When you're experimenting with different options, another thing you can tweak is just the time that you're offering the class. So maybe you're somebody who, you know, is a morning person and you prefer to have morning classes and you've only opened up morning slots, and it might be a good idea to experiment with offering afternoon classes. You are serving a global audience, so your class may appeal to, you know, students in America over students in Europe. It's a good idea to play around with the time just to see how that works for you. And of course, another thing that you can experiment with is also the price. So you can start off offering something that's a little bit more inexpensive. And then as you gain parents' trust, as you gain more of a reputation within OutSchool and you get more reviews and prove that you are super fun and super engaging, then you can charge a little bit more for your courses or create another course that kind of dives deeper into that topic. Okay, so another tip for getting enrollments is to improve your profile. So you want to make sure that you have an intro video for your profile. So this is not the same intro video that you would submit for your application, because the audience for that intro video is the OutSchool hiring team, right? So for this intro video, you want one that speaks directly to parents. It could also speak to students too, but ultimately the parents are making the decision to buy your course. So usually you're kind of marketing to the parents. But basically you're talking about your background and your expertise and kind of your passions. And it kind of draws people in because they have a sense of who you are, what your style of teaching is. It really just gives the parents an opportunity to get to know you and just build that trust, right? Build that rapport so they know, okay, I trust that this person seems like they are an expert in XYZ. So I definitely would love to have my child take a class with them. Another tip that is in your control is to improve your actual class listing. So again, parents are going to be reviewing this, students are going to be reviewing this, and you want to make sure that they have a clear idea of what to expect in class. That way they're excited about taking a class with you. So another way to do that, of course, a better way to do that always is to connect with them via video, because then they have a little bit of a window inside what to expect. So I feel like video always helps your class listing. So again, don't overthink it, but just explaining a little bit more about what they can expect in your class will go a long way. Okay, that's it for now, guys. I don't want to overwhelm you. I'll probably be coming out with a part two for this video, but for now, that is all I have to share with you guys. Again, no worries, because OutSchool really does a great job of marketing your classes, and I mean that. But these are just some tips if you want to kind of increase your chances tenfold of getting enrollments. If you guys have more questions about OutSchool, I encourage you guys to take a look at my channel and watch some of my other videos that go a little bit more into depth about the application process, how to apply. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'm happy to help you apply. I'm gonna be your referring teacher. I can give you a ton of different resources that will help you through the process and just get you hired much more quickly. So feel free to reach out to me. I'm gonna leave my referral link below, and I will also leave my email below so that you guys know exactly where to find me. Hope that was helpful, and I will see you guys in the next video.